And Richard Southern joins us. Richard, the Habs have definitely been the better team on the ice, but that hasn't stopped Vegas from, well, trolling their Canadian opponents.
Vegas has the best troll game going on. Case in point, what happened last night in Vegas, Eric, on the big screen there in the arena, which, by the way, is jam-packed in Vegas, they put up a picture of Montreal native Celine Dion. And what was she wearing? A Vegas Golden Knights helmet and jersey. Uh-oh. Has Celine changed teams?
Oh.
Look at that, Erica.
Was
shocking.
That photoshopped? Yeah.
That's the question, but I love the Montreal Gazette picked up on this, and this is the Montreal Gazette. They write, quote, "We see how it is. The beauty has chosen the beast," wrote the Gazette.
Nice.
They were not happy.
Yeah.
Not happy in Montreal.
Yeah.
Yes, you're right. There are questions about whether that was an actual picture or whether it was photoshopped. However, in 2018, Celine did appear with a Vegas Golden Knights jersey on during one of her Vegas shows.
Celine.
So there might be something to it. Maybe her heart's not going on for the Habs, Erica.
That residency makes big bucks for Celine. So,
and she's going to be in a new place there that's opening on the Strip, apparently.
Yep.
She's forgotten about Montreal. She's in Vegas now.
Her heart doesn't go on with Montreal. Okay, the Pope has shaken hands with some of the most powerful people in the world. And now that list includes a superhero, Richard.
Spider-Man met the Pope today in the Vatican. He swung in and met Pope Francis at a private audience. Spider-Man was seen sitting in a VIP section, and there he is, meeting
Spider-Man
the Pope.
And the Pope.
Two powerful men right there.
Feels
and he
like
gave the Pope a, what's that, Erica?
I don't know, it feels like the plot line of something, but anyways, go on.
Yes, they're in some sort of underground lair planning to rescue someone. He gave the Pope a Spider-Man face mask. Turns out, playing Spider-Man, standing in for him here, was a 27-year-old man from northern Italy who was being celebrated for visiting children's hospitals dressed as different superhero characters to cheer them up. So that's why Pope wanted to honor him. But yeah, that's pretty neat to see the Pope hanging out with. That's my favorite superhero because Spider-Man, as you know, Peter Parker, a struggling photojournalist. I really identify with Spider-Man in many
ways.
That's
right. Okay, and finally, are you feeling a little tired and worn down? Japan is toying with a radical idea to help improve work-life balance.
Big news. Out of the world's second largest economy, Japan suggested the companies in that country allow workers to go down to a four-day work week instead of the traditional five. They said it would help companies retain employees who might otherwise have to take off to take care of family. They said it will also help employees get more education. More so, they said the extra day off will have people going out and spending more, and that will boost the economy. We've heard more and more, you know, companies and countries talk about the possibility of a four-day work week, but Japan, certainly the biggest to do it so far. Of course, we're on board. You're on board with this, right, Erica?
Yeah, I think so, and it'll be interesting to see if they do it, how it plays out, right? Because then maybe we can adopt that over here.
That would be great. I mean, I would have more patio bar bills to pay if it was a three-day weekend, but I'd still embrace it.
The restaurants will thank you, Richard.
They would love me.
All right. Thanks, Richard. We'll see you tomorrow.
See you tomorrow.